Hello, everybody. I'm tired. Right. I'm ready. Well, I'm not ready, but it's time to make a start on the bottom shelf, the base of the unit, or the base of the shelves. I do just want to show, obviously, the difference in colour that I've created so far. So obviously I've gone from this very, very light wood, coloured wood, to a much darker wood. I have given that a quick little final sanding. I must admit I'm teetering on the edge of, I think they need another clear coat. But I was prepared for that. I want to see how it's gonna how the stain is gonna go on to the much fresher wood, because it's going to react very differently with this than it did with that. So what I'm going to be doing now is basically taking this shelf completely apart, and it's made up of what, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, about 10 pieces. So I'm going to need to take it apart, give each piece a light sanding, check each piece over for any bits that may need repairs, and I will, if there are, I'll deal with those. I'll work out if there's anything that needs repairing, and then I'll go through a stage of repairing them all before I put any stain on. So anyway, right, I realised I've left a tub in there, but I need to go and take this back out of the way anyway. Ooh. Now, interestingly, recently I changed to a no nicotine e-juice, and excuse me, I've been finding myself more and more not using it. As I say, I'm about to use it. Right. There's only one thing to do, and that is to crack on, really. Fucking seesaw. Just to support it. Videos to do with this, I mentioned about some of my smaller screws which I'd ended up having to use a smaller screw than I wanted. I have already gone through and replaced all those, did that before I brought everything here. Now, I must admit, I'm looking at this piece and I can see there's a damaged bit here. It has got quite a big split on it. Now, I'm in two minds, because I know on another piece of the other woods I've done where there was a bit that was missing, and I actually said it added a nice bit of character to it. Well, I like that, but the way that this is splitting, if I was to just pull this out, chances are it could split much, much deeper. So what I might do is I might have a look at getting my Stanley blade and just carving away at it a bit, so that I can get it sort of picked out nicely. Now up this end there is a couple of cracks here. I'm not worried about those at all, really. That's just a feature, gonna have to be a feature of the wood. But these big splits, they end up, they're the kind of things that if I don't deal with it, it could be a splintering situation. But also, if at any point this does come off, then underneath it would not be stained and then it looks shit. So they're the kind of things I have to consider. So a little bit of repair work needed on that one. Yeah, so here I've already taken out a bit there. So I do like the fact that it does, it definitely gives the wood a bit of a feature. Gives it a bit of character, not caricature, character. So I'm definitely looking forward to staining this. Hopefully what I'm going to be able to do with this is, whereas with the oak finish varnish, see that soaked in really quickly, right? But it didn't give a lot of colour to the wood. Whereas using the deep mahogany on this, it should soak in rapidly, right? But while also colouring the wood. It also means as well that wiping off any excess should be much better on this, because there will only be excess if the wood has not soaked it in, or if I left a big splodge somewhere. So hopefully we'll go a bit nicer, but I may start off with some of the timbers that are at the back of the shelving unit, just to get a good view, or at least perhaps do all of the studded timber before I do the panel timber, at least the first coat. Admittedly, there is a specific way that all of this fits together as well, which I have taken no record of. So it will come to bite me in the ass later on. It's all part of the fun. Right, let's check these timbers over for damage. No, that's fine. So I've got a little bit of repair work to do over there at the moment, that is it. Obviously I'm going to need to do the repair work before I do any sanding or anything. But yeah, so as you might be able to tell, the number of pieces of studding timber, and then four pieces of the shelf. So what I will probably do is go through doing these and seeing how it gets on with these before I really move on to that. Now what that could mean, let's see, what I could do is sand these down, move these into my living room so that I can carve that bit of wood out while I'm waiting for these to dry after having the first coat of stain on. It's not a bad idea, that. Right, let me move these out of the way. Now I've got my supports, but obviously I'm a bit fucking bigger than them. Very narrow, but that's a problem. I haven't really got any other scrap bits of wood, but I don't really want to use the shelves. Oh. that didn't work. Beat the fucking dumb. I might just have to go with it, you know. And just be careful with that one. So, I'm going to go with my fine sander, sanding sheet, not my super fine, just my fine. Get my damp cloth ready. Now, for anyone that's maybe interested as to what day it is today, I can let you know it's the day after Boris basically did the first lockdown. I say the first, I don't know if there'll be an additional one, but I wouldn't be surprised if there is. Well, it is interesting. I think everything I've been through over the last 5 years, you know, in a way, has prepared me for this time. Because just as all this shit has sort of kicked off, all the things that have been a problem in my life for the last 5 years have kind of been coming to an end. And regarding social distancing and stuff like that, I do that anyway. It's got a very, very fuzzy bit there. Now you may notice that I'm sort of light sanding this a bit more than I normally would. That's because obviously it's the first light sanding for this piece since I brought it here. So I want to try and make sure that there's no oiling off bits. Now, although it might mean that I end up with quite a bit of sawdust on the arm, but that's what the damp cloth's for. And I could sand them all and then wipe each one off individually, but I figured doing it this way gives each piece time to dry. I mean, you can probably tell as well, I mean, you look how sort of light coloured these are compared to the bits I've just finished. It just goes to show just how much colour they did take. I think it's very easy though to not be able to see the wood for the trees. Also, this wood is already, I mean, it's soaking in this pretty quickly, which is no surprise really. It does mean it is going to soak in the stain, hopefully beautifully. To be honest, I would expect all of these pieces of wood to actually come out nicer than the pillars because of them having the oak on. Oh, I wasn't going to do that one first. So I set them up so that the big one can stay here so I don't have to keep reaching for it. Feel there's a lot more dust coming off these than there was the bits of timber, but I suppose I am using a coarser grade paper, but I may have to close one of my doors in a minute. I suppose I could open the window that's there. I must admit the last two or three days have been absolutely beautiful days weather wise. Which I can understand why it's tempted some people to ignore health instructions and just fuck off outside and go on holiday and go pub and group up and all that shit. But I see it as a test. The weather's really nice. What are you going to do? Are you going to ignore health measures and potentially die or kill others? Or are you going to be sensible and stay the fuck at home? Which... it's the easiest of things to do. Although I was thinking, I might have actually mentioned it in a previous video about the younger generations that may be involved in drinking drugs and stuff like that. And they're going to want to get out of the house to go and have a smoke with their mates and shit like that, because their parents might not know that that's what they do. I mean, I'm not a parent, but if I was going to give any advice to parents, it'd be, look, give your kids a bit of a pass here and tell them, look, it don't matter what the fuck you do, just do it at home for the time being. Let's face it, if there was ever a time for the nation to get fucking to smoke a big fat blunt, get fucking wasted, chill out, and have a laugh. Now's the time. Now would be a good time for people to teach their kids how to do things like make bread, or even make pasta, rather than going and buying, or for the moment not being able to buy them. The table I've got that is still in the car. I've been trying to work out whether I'm just going to try sanding that down or whether I should go for the chemical. And I'm thinking I'll go with the chemical stripper to begin with, at least, anyway. One, because my experience with the using the furniture stripper is that if you use the right stuff on the right stuff, it fucking helps massively. And if there's anything I've learned from my orbital sander, it's that it likes to either shred through sheets, which means I've probably got it on too fast a setting, or the sheets were getting so dirty when I was sanding all these that the sheets would no longer stick to the pad. But anyway, and now it could just be a dirt thing. I did make a fucking mess. My memory will be running out soon, but I'll be able to go upload that onto the computer. How are you feeling today? Bad joke, I know. Out of that one. That will need filling in. That's too big a thing to leave. Okay, so I've got a little bit of repair work to do on there. Not to bang it. Right on toward the gum. Trying to think if I've already done that. Did I already do that? I can't remember. We'll go over it again. I did because, sorry, my nose is itching. I did because there was the rough bit. Okay, so and give this a wipe down, and then I'm going to need to do a repair on that bit that's got a bit of a gap on it. But before I go on to doing any of that, I think I'm going to get my vac and give the table a clean and just vac around me, because this has created a bit more dust than I was really expecting it to. Let that dry off, take a break for a minute, and get this table sorted out. I'll be back shortly.